strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Come on, bring justice to me.
Thy faithfulness on your program. Hallelujah.
Great is thy faithfulness, O
Jesus, great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Do you see this as the words of a song? Or are we being faithful? Faithfulness means true, means loyal, constant. God is always true to us. He constantly here with us, loving us, having mercy upon us. And he's always loyal to us. But where is our faithfulness to him? Separate and apart from community and public worship, we all need to get together in private and pray to strengthen our faithfulness and to live a fulfilling life. In him, great is thy faithfulness. Wonderful. Good morning again, everyone. Good morning to the leaders of this army. This morning, I welcome you all to another men's service. And the theme this morning is the Lord is our shepherd. The Lord is our shepherd. And it sets an explicit metaphor because we, the community of believers, are the sheep and God is a shepherd tending to us. And with him as our shepherd, what? We shall never what? Want. Amen? Hallelujah. Coming to you now, the prayer is our dear brother Dalton Barrett, followed by the scripture reading, which will be coming to you from 2 Timothy 1, reading from verses 1 to 18, and that will be done by our brother, Leighton Taylor.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All that I have needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness. Great is thy faithfulness, O Lord, unto us. Father, we give you thanks this morning. We thank you for the privilege to be standing, my mighty God, in your presence one more time. As the songwriter just said, great is thy faithfulness unto your people. We thank you, mighty God, for this privilege. And as we come, Lord, we pray, Holy Father, that we'll come with a receptive heart this morning to receive thy word. We pray even now, mighty God, that as we come in one accord this morning, O mighty God, our heart, mighty God, we incline, my mighty God, to whatever, mighty God, your word will offer for unto us. Heavenly Father, we of ourselves can't do nothing. But we are standing on your word, mighty God, believing, mighty God, because we know, mighty God, whatever you say, mighty God, that will you do for us. We just want to thank you this morning as we come another time in your presence. So ask me, mighty God, that you lead and direct this service as we lift up, mighty God, our pastors, our pastoral team this morning unto you, mighty God, and their families. And, mighty God, those who, mighty God, are visiting with us this morning in we ask, mighty God, that you send forth a word, mighty God. Mighty God, they have been coming months, month after months, and year after year, mighty God. And they have not, mighty God, some of them accept you as Lord and Savior. We ask even now, mighty God, that you touch their hearts this morning. Let this morning be a morning of repentance unto you, mighty God. Let they accept you as Lord and Savior. We pray, oh, mighty God, for our ushers, mighty God. Our media room, mighty God. Our leaders, mighty God, in the pastoral team, mighty God. We thank you, mighty God, for guiding us thus far. We know, mighty God, this pandemic, mighty God, is upon us. But we know you are greater than this pandemic. We know, mighty God, it's because of you why many of us are here this morning. It is nothing good that we have done, but we know, mighty God of Daniel, your love for us, mighty God, your compassion for us, mighty God, will keep us because we know, my God, you are our Lord and Savior. We look neither to the left nor to the right, but we look to you, our Lord and our God. Bless the one who will bring forth your word this morning, mighty God, and help us, mighty God, to come with a heart to accept your word. We pray, oh my God, that this atmosphere will be conducive for worship as we place everything into your unchanging hands. Lead and direct, my God, those who are out there, my mighty God, and media, mighty God, watching us this morning. We pray for them. We pray for the shutting. We pray for those who couldn't have made it this morning because of what is happening in this nation, right, mighty God. But we know, mighty God, this gives them an opportunity to be closer to you, mighty God. Because, mighty God, the songwriter says, shut a teen with God, mighty God. We ask, mighty God, that you touch them wherever they are, mighty God, as they listen, mighty God, to your word this morning. May your word penetrate, mighty God, every aspect of their lives and help them, mighty God, to be closer to you. We come this morning with a humble heart and an obedient spirit to your will and to your way. Whatever is your will, Lord, we pray that thy will be done this morning. Take full control, mighty God, of every situation this morning. Let everything that was said and done this morning bring glory and honor unto your holy name. We thank you that you have heard our prayer this morning. Thank you that you have answered. We thank you for what you have done, what you are about to do for us this morning. As we lift our hands this morning, Heavenly Father, in worship to you, so we lift your name above every name. A name that every knee shall bow and every tongue confess that thou art Christ, the Son of the living God. To the glory of God the Father who sits upon the heavenly throne, we thank you, mighty God, for who you are. Have your sweet way among us this morning as we avail ourselves to you, to use by you for your glory and for your honor. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the blessed Holy Spirit. Amen. Hallelujah.
Church. Today's scripture reading is taken from 2 Timothy chapter 1, and we'll be reading the entire chapter. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ, by the will of God, according to the promise of life, which is in Christ Jesus. To Timothy, my dearly loved son, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord. I thank God, whom I serve from my forefathers with pure conscience, that without ceasing I have remembrance of thee in my prayers night and day, greatly desiring to see thee, being mindful of thy tears, that I may be filled with joy when I call to remembrance the unfeigned faith that is in thee, which dwelt first in thy grandmother Lois and thy mother Eunice. And I am persuaded that in thee also. Therefore I put thee in remembrance, that thou stir up the gift of God which is in thee by the putting on of my hands. For God hath not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Be not therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord, nor of me, his prisoner, but be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel according to the power of God, who has saved us and called us with a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his own purpose and grace, which was given us in Christ Jesus before the world began, but is now made manifest by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who hath abolished death and hath brought life and immortality to light through the gospel. Whereunto I am appointed a preacher, an apostle, and a teacher of the Gentiles, for the which cause I also suffer these things. Nevertheless, I am not ashamed, for I know whom I have believed, and I am persuaded that he is able to keep that which I have committed unto him against that day. Hold fast the form of sound words which thou hast heard of me in faith and love which is in Christ Jesus. That good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost which dwelleth in us. This thou knowest, that all they which are in Asia be turned away from me, of whom are Phygellus and Hermogenes. The Lord give mercy unto the house of Onesiphorus, for he hath refreshed me, and was not ashamed of my chain. But when he was in Rome, he sought me out very diligently and found me. 18 and last. The Lord grant unto him that he may find mercy of the Lord in that day, and in how many things he ministered unto me at Ephesus, thou knowest very well. Here endeth the reading of God's holy word. We honor it by saying, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Ghost, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall it be, world without end. Amen.
Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Brother Barrett. Thank you, Layton, for the word. And now we will have a PR representative coming to you to give you a better welcome than I did this morning. And immediately after the PR representative, we'll be having a declaration of faith, and that will be done by our host pastor, Reverend Alexander Sims.
Open unto me the gates of righteousness, and I will go into them and praise the Lord. Why don't you just lift your hands in the presence of the Almighty God and just give him a wave offering. Indeed, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Holy Spirit a clap offering. Give the Father a clap offering. And give the Son a clap offering. Indeed, we are happy to be in the house of the Lord, yet another men's Sunday. And we worship God in the beauty of holiness. So this morning, I wanted to take the time out to welcome those of you who have taken the time to visit with us. And so with this, I ask if there are any first-time visitors, just to raise your hand at this moment so we can acknowledge you. I see your hand. I'm going to ask you to stand. All right, if you're upstairs, I'm going to ask you to stand also. Eastwood Park, give a warm welcome. We are indeed glad that you're here this morning, and there is a blessing here for you. You are in Liberty Hall. Don't go home leaving your blessing. God bless you. Be seated. Thank you. And all our regular visitors, could just give us a wave offering. Yes, we look forward to having Sunday after Sunday. We welcome you in the presence of God. Continue to worship Him. And we have some special persons here, our young converts. Any of our young converts that got baptized last Sunday? Yes. Stand. Beautiful, beautiful. They're all over the place. Oh, new babes in Christ. Give them a better hand than that in Eastwood Park. Hallelujah. We want to welcome you to the faith. And we know that you're going to grow in God. Just continue to worship Him and to take time out to be with the brethren. Because definitely when you assemble yourself with the brethren, you are sharpened. God bless you. Please be seated. We also have a very special visitor in our midst. The U.S. Ambassador, that's Ambassador Donald Tapia, is here. We ask you to stand at this moment so we can acknowledge you. Eastwood Park Road, put your hands together and make him welcome. We are glad to have you, sir, and you are in Liberty Hall. Feel free to worship God in the beauty of holiness. And we have Jeremiah Knight. Please stand so he can make you welcome too, Jeremiah. Welcome back. Yes. Beautiful. Now our senior citizens have been coming out one by one. But if this is your first time back since COVID-19, could you just stand so we could acknowledge you? Yes, beautiful. Wonderful. Brother Sam, Brother Egbert Sam, and Sister Joyce Sam, as we see you, we're glad to have you back. Put your hands together for them. Beautiful. We celebrate each time we have our senior citizens coming to join us. And so, I just wanted to say to you all that your faith can move mountains. Lift your faith in Christ as you continue to worship Him. God bless you. Do have a rich day.
Continue to worship the Lord. Continue to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. It is good to be in the house of the Lord. You know, I looked over and I saw the person looking at Brother Sam. But I could not specifically because of the mask. I've never seen him in a mask before. So I couldn't recognize. But it's good to see you, Brother Sam, Sister Sam, and all our seniors that have just come out. And I want to greet those at home who have not come yet. And let me say, it is truly wonderful to have with us Ambassador Donald Tapia. And I am going to invite him this time to bring greetings to us. Would you put your hands together and make him welcome? And of course, he's not coming for the first time.
Generous blessing that this morning I read something that's very appropriate. It talked about the Bible. And in the Bible it says there are no white churches. There are no black churches. Jesus died not for our skin. He died for our souls. I truly believe that. I am a believer, and I want to thank you for extending your kind welcome here to me. Thank you. God bless.
Father, in the name of Jesus, we commend your son to you at this time. And I ask that you touch him even now. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. The devil is alive. And he will not get victory. All right, we trust the Lord that everything will be all right. We continue, and we will be having now the declaration of faith. May I invite you to stand? Just before you stand, let me ask the young converts, those who were baptized on Sunday morning, to stand. All right. I'm sorry, but I have to disturb some persons. So those persons who are sitting in the first, second, third, just exchange seat to one of the persons who is standing so they can come down. No, you can stay, my brother. You can stay. You're already in the front. All right. Where are the ushers? Wow. My sister, you're going to have to change. Yes, you have to change seat. Where are the ushers? The ushers need to exchange. Ensure that. So they come down and we are going to the other bench. So just look and follow us and work with us, right? Right. Do we have any other for young converts out there? Right. We just got to do it right. All right. So everybody stand. Let's put our hands together for the young converts. It is 2, 4, 6, 8, 9, 9 of 21. Praise God. 10. All right. 10 of 21. Now we go to the declaration of faith. All right, there's a seat. Come down here, sweetheart. That's okay? Come down. Go over there. All right. All right. So now we go. We believe in the verbal inspiration of the Bible, in one God, eternally existing. Three persons, namely the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, that Jesus Christ is the only begotten Son of the Father, conceived of the Holy Ghost, and born of the Virgin Mary, that Jesus was crucified, buried, and raised from the dead, that he ascended to heaven, and is today at the right hand of the Father as the intercessor, that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, that repentance is commanded of God for all and necessary for the forgiveness of sins, that justification regeneration, and the new birth wrought by faith in the blood of Jesus Christ, in sanctification subsequent to the new birth, through faith in the blood of Christ, through the Word, and by the Holy Ghost. Holiness to God's standard of living for His people, in the baptism with the Holy Ghost, subsequent to a clean heart, in speaking with other tongues as Spirit gives utterance, and that is the initial evidence of the baptism of the Holy Ghost, in water baptism by immersion. And all who repent should be baptized in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Divine healing is provided for all in the atonement, in the Lord's Supper, and washing of the saints' feet, in the premillennial second coming of Jesus, first to resurrect the righteous dead, and to catch away the living saints to him in the air, second to reign on earth 1,000 years, in the bodily resurrection, eternal life for the righteous, and eternal punishment for the wicked. Amen. You may be seated.
Hallelujah. At this time, we will have a special item by our brother Delroy McCarthy. And immediately after is the offertory by Councillor Everton Samuels. Thank you.
Good morning, church.
Good morning. Hallelujah. It's good to be alive. Jesus is alive and well. How are you doing? Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. For a long time I traveled on a long, lonely road. My heart was so heavy, in sin I sunk low. And I heard about Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus.
What a wonderful day. My heart, show me the way. Thank God I am free, free, free from this world of sin. And washed in the blood of Jesus, been born again. Hallelujah, I'm saved, 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 saved by His wonderful day. I'm so glad that I
Brothers and sisters, what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me? I'll offer up sacrifices of praise, thanksgiving, and worship to him. We have come to a very, very important part of our worship when we give to God, and we cannot pay him for all he has done for us. We will never in all our life be able to pay God, because he has been so good to us. He gave his only son, Jesus Christ, on the cross of Calvary to save us from sin and to redeem us. And today, we're going to give a sacrificial offering to him today. We're not looking for something from God. We just want to show him that we really love him and appreciate him, because it's our duty to honor him and to give to him. So let us just give up our best. Only our best is good enough. So let us give the best offering today, the best tithes unto the Lord today. Let us all stand. I'm going to raise an offering and tithes to the Lord as I pray God's blessing upon the offering and tithes today. Let us all stand. Let us pray. Our great, mighty God, we honor you today, Lord, because all good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your love. Lord, we thank you today, Lord, because, God, you are the one who have provided jobs for us that we can go out and work. You are the one who gave us the health and the strength and the courage that, Lord, we can go out and work on a daily basis, on a weekly basis, on a monthly basis. And so today, Lord, we are here in your house, God, to give an offering to you, Lord, to show our appreciation, to show our love for your mercies and your benefits towards us. So, Lord, as we come into your house, let us give of our best to you. Lord, we pray, oh God, for someone today, my God, a bill to pay, a mortgage to pay, I need a house, need a car, or something from you today, Lord. Help them to realize that they can give their way to their blessing. And so, Lord, we pray, God, that you'll touch them. And God, we pray for those that are without jobs. Lord, some of you might have lost their job due to the COVID-19. But God, you are a God of plenty. And God, even in the economic crisis, you provide jobs for your children. You promote your children. And so today, God, we know that you're a great God. So Lord, we ask you to open doors for those persons who need jobs, that Lord can give to your work. Bless the offering and tithes today that should be given unto you. Bless and sanctify in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. The choristers lead us in worship as we give unto the Lord.
Streets that are golden, and I want to run where the angels have trod. Sing, Jerusalem, I want to rest on the banks of the river,
in that city
of God. John saw a city that could not be hid. John saw the city.
Oh, yes, he did.
John caught a glimpse of the golden throne. Tell me all about it.
Go right on.
Around the throne, he saw the crystal sea. There's got to be more.
What will it be?
I want to go to that city. So, New Jerusalem,
I want to walk the streets that are golden.
I want to run
where the angels have trod. Banks of your river, in thy city of God.
Holy, holy, holy,
holy,
holy, holy, holy.
Receive honor, worthy to receive all our praises.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy, holy, holy, holy,
holy,
holy is the Lord God Almighty.
Sing worthy.
Exalt his name forever.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, thank you. You all have been a wonderful audience so far, so keep it up. Now, we're at the moment when we will be hearing the word from the man, our own Reverend Garfield Blair. And as he comes to you, I'm going to ask all of you to stand and make him welcome. My name is Roger Limsang, and it was really a pleasure and an honor being your moderator this morning. Walk good, live good, love everybody that you come inside to. Be blessed. Bless you.
Hallelujah. Just worship the Lord. Give him all the glory, the honor. Give him all the praise that is due to his wonderful name. He alone deserves our worship. He alone deserves our praise. He alone deserves to be adored. He alone deserves to be magnified. He alone deserves to be exalted. He alone deserves to be extolled. He is God with us. He's God for us. He's in control of everything that happens to us. He's God this morning. Somebody worship him. Somebody exalt him. Somebody adore him. Somebody bless him. Somebody praises him. Somebody has love on him this morning. Because he alone deserves our worship. He alone deserves our praise. He alone deserves the exalted and extolled. Father, I come to you this morning in no other name but the name of Jesus. God, I present my body before you again and myself to your work and to your word. I pray that you'll anoint this lump of flesh, that I will speak, just said the Lord. I pray, God, that your word will go forth to proceed, and that the heart of your people will be blessed and challenged. I come against every spirit right now that is not like you and of you. And I pray for peace and peace of God. I pray that you will just comfort us this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Let church say amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of our God and Father. I felt led this morning before I share what the Lord has given me to pray for persons this morning. We did it in fasting. I felt led as I was praying in the weary morning this morning, preparing myself to pray for those persons here this morning. You're believing God for a miracle. A miracle. Something that is out of the normal. Something that is supernatural. Hey, God Almighty, I don't know if you understand what I'm talking about. Can you just play a part of that song for me? Sasha Cobb sing this song and I love it. There's a miracle in the house with your name on it. Hey!
There's a miracle in this room.
And your name on it.
With my name on it.
My name on it.
Hey! There's a healing in this room.
Hey!
And it's here for me.
Come on now.
Oh, there's a breakthrough. In this room, it's got my name on it. So I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Put a praise on it this morning.
I'm gonna put a praise on it.
Am I talking to somebody?
Somebody put a praise on it. There's a miracle in this room. We're tossing the name.
Call your name. There's a miracle.
Name in the
hey, there's a miracle in the house. And it has my name on it. Whatever the miracle is this morning, look at it. I'm going to put a praise on it.
So I'm going to put a praise on it.
Hey! Somebody praise me!
Put a praise on it. Can you help me put a praise on it?
Hey! Put a praise on it this morning.
Put a praise
on it this morning.
Let's go!
Of Jesus, you're a miracle working God. You never stop work miracles. You never stop work sign and wonders. You are the same yesterday, today, and forever. Today we come to the same God. Oh, Laba Soko Deba Sike, who has never changed. A God that is immutable in your character, power, and person. So right now, God, there's a miracle in the house with my name on it, and I believe you for it. I receive it, and I praise you for it, Lord. Hey, just thank him, somebody. Thank him, somebody. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, release that miracle. Release that miracle. In the hospital right now, no God, where that embassy is, he's released a miracle in the name of Jesus. And we just worship him, worship him, worship him, worship him. Somebody just worship him. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hey, Jesus. Hey, Jesus. Lord Jesus, I love you. You know what I would talk about? The lady that was a Gentile woman, and she came to Jesus Christ having a condition. Her daughter was sick, and the Bible said when she came to Jesus and she could call out to Jesus, Jesus said, not meet for me to give you the children bread, or to give the children bread to the dog. But the Bible said she was so desperate that she bowed down and worshiped him. The first place of reference, she worshiped. And then Jesus get her attention. And she said, even crumbs is good for the dog that fall from the table. I don't know if you understand what I'm talking about. Worship can change your condition. Your worship can change your situation. I know been preached that. That's not my message, but that's a word of encouragement. When you're faced with your blue mountain or your Jericho wall, learn to worship, man. Learn to bow down and say, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue. Be in my mouth. Hey, God, I don't want to talk to somebody today. You are discouraged because of your condition. Start worship. Just start praising him. You see, the song say he has a miracle in the house and he has your name on it. So it can't pass and come to Brother Blair. It comes directly to you. So you have to open up and receive the worship. I greet my pastor, pastoral team, the councilmen and ladies. You wonderful saints, I greet you well. And those up on the internet, big up yourself. I greet you in Jesus' name. The topic that I'd like to share on this morning in my short discourse, stay committed Don't compromise. Stay committed. Don't compromise. We are living in a time and age where relativism, humanistic ideas, is a norm of the day. In other words, then, there's no truth that people want to speak these. It is easy to rationalize the truth than to speak it. Because the truth, Jesus said, will bring offense. And this morning, I want to share a point with you about being committed. What it means to be committed? It means to pledge or to bound to a certain course of policy, or the simple word, to be dedicated. You cannot conquer what you are not committed to. T.D. Jakes quote that. You cannot conquer what you are not committed to. Abraham Lincoln says, what commitment is what transforms a promise into a reality. Oh, God Almighty. So, I want us to look at some of the things that we need to stay committed to. You need to stay committed to your consecration. Consecration, set apart. We are not normal people. Bishop, when Jesus Christ called us, he called us with a holy calling. So must stay consecrated, dedicated for the purpose and use of Almighty God. Too much people are playing around with consecration. And you wonder why the Holy Ghost can't move in the church like it used to move before? Because we are using people that are not consecrated. You can't be committed but not consecrated. Talk to me. Consecrated is a different level from commitment. Set heart. Hey, God Almighty, identify with Christ. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 20. Look at what Jesus did to bring us consecration. A new and living way which he had consecrated for us through the veil. That is to say, it's flesh. And having a high priest over the house of God, let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our body washed with pure water. I have a concern that these days we accept every and anybody in the pulpit of the church these days. I have a concern. Some people who are homosexual and them in a pulpit to preach and at the praise and worship. Some of them have concubinage lifestyle and them in the praise and worship. If we worship God with those kind of lifestyle, you don't know what the Bible say. You are bought a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body, which is His. You cannot conceal sin and think you're going to be at the church for long. God will expose it one day. And I think He's fixing His church to come back for His church. A glorious church without spot or wrinkle or any such thing. Commit yourself to consecration and dedication. That is prayer God can move in the church again. I am not saying we are perfect. But my God, identify a need in your life that you need to change. Cry out to the Lord. That's what David said when Nehemiah, the prophet, Nehemiah said, come and says to him. And he cry out and he said, Lord, create in me a clean heart. I renew a right spirit within me. Consecration is needed. Consecration is necessary. And that's why we now see the power of God move again. Because we have lost our pulpit to all kind of things. And the power of God can move again. That's why God wants to move, because the consecration is not here. I know you're not going to show today, but this is the truth. You have to stay consecrated. Stay committed. The Bible says, know ye not that your body is a living, is the temple of the Holy Ghost. Eh? That's why the Bible says, know ye not that your body is at the temple of the Holy Ghost. Jesus lives right there. And you can't live and do anything like you please. You can't have your girlfriend when you come and sing. And you have your girlfriend. And you have a hug up and do all kind of things. And you want to come sing for the people. And you want to come pray to. Huh? You know right? Let it go. Consecrate yourself. Let me tell you something. If you're not ready, stay till you get ready. Some people put jumps us, you know. You know, them can't cheer and them live a certain way, but they still want to take part. Fix yourself first. Jesus spent 40 days and 40 nights to fix himself in wilderness. Right, Bishop? He was tempted by the devil in all points. All points. He was tested and tempted. And he never succumbed. Still consecrated. Bishop, we need to get back the Holy Ghost discernment in the church again. That when them come to preach, or they come to sing, Holy Ghost take them off and say, sit down till ready. And if they want to leave the church after them business. We need to get back to that place. And the Holy Ghost ever tell you this. You can't fix God's church for him. Me can't say, never use it until you change. Me can't do that. You don't make that decision. Sometimes we say, my son driving, you know, and him, when he just start driving, going like him a driver. And he mash up the car a couple of times. And I say, you're suspended. Right, Bishop? Me can't know, say, he's going to mash up the car again and make him keep driving the car. And he cost me. He's still and take your bus. You know what time he take the bus to school and car there? Until he learn. If you realize that he's not up on the highway. And he's not a Formula One driver. He just start. You understand what I'm talking about? Some of we want to take them, put them. Before we tell them to deal with this now, the situation that they have. God not pleased with it. Make them fix them house. Before you put them up on the stage. Because them remember you see when they come on the stage. You understand what I'm talking about? Stay consecrated. Don't make nothing move your consecration. Don't make nobody move your consecration. Stay committed to consecration. We used to sing a song in the church. I don't hear it sing again. Consecrate me, Lord, to thy service, Lord. By the power of grace, by. Hey! Draw me what, Bishop? Nearer, blessed Lord. Hey! To thy precious bleeding side. And there's a part that said, till my will be lost in thine. Draw me nearer, my precious Lord. I want to get nearer than yesterday. Draw me nearer to that precious bleeding side. I'm thine, O Lord. I have heard thy call. Jesus Christ, Almighty God. You know what happens to some of us? We don't know who called or what we call for. But when you know who called you, you see, the songwriter, draw me nearer to that precious bleeding side. Jesus coming back for a church that is washed, thoroughly, pure and ready. Time for us to stop your church. Get committed. Get consecrated. Spend time in the Word of God. Spend time in prayer and fasting. Brother Roger, you know why I grew into the church? I used to come prayer, mother. Them beats out of you. Because yes, when you go to church, then jump on you. And then lay them Bible upon you. And then say, get you. Them said, they would say, let go. Hold on. Let go and hold on. You know what I'm telling you? Let go of a sin and hold on for Jesus. And then I beat the Bible over your head. And remember, when we see them, I have to make sure that we repent 10 times. Because we know that they just say, come here, boy. What's going on in your life? We need to get back to them place there again in the church. Hey, God Almighty, we're the mother and the father of Zion. We have them Holy Ghost discernment to see what is happening, to know what is happening, and help young people. They are challenged now with all kind of something. Ears ring. Some of them man have ears ring coming to church. Our culture not deal with that. What's that in the Bible? Lose the consecration. Take it off. Stop at it off. Any man in Christ that knew what? All things what? And be all. Stay committed to consecration. Stay committed to worship. You see, the Bible said Jesus spoke up the lady at the well in St. John 4, verse 20. And Jesus tell her about worship. And she said, "Our Father, worship in this mountain." And Jesus said, "I don't know what you worship. How you worship?" But him said, "The Father seeketh such to worship. But they that worship must worship in what? Spirit." Let me tell you something. Everybody can praise the Lord, but it's not everybody can worship him. There's a difference between worship and there's a difference between praise. You praise him for who he is and what he has done, but you worship him because, oh Lord Jesus Christ, you must understand you can't worship God effectively if you're not connected in the spirit, because God is a spirit. God can't relate to us outside of the spirit. You understand what I'm talking about? So when you worship, you must worship in spirit and truth. This morning I've enjoyed the worship service. Bishop gone. Let me tell you something. Even my preaching is good, but it's not better than worship. Because something about when you worship God. Hey Lord Jesus Christ. When you bow down and you kneel before him and you worship him. There's a presence that comes from him when you start to worship him. There's something he does in your life to start to worship him. Worship brings him into the earthly realm. When you worship him in spirit and in truth, it brings God into the earthly realm to work for you. That's what he does. Read the Bible. Every worshiper receive a victory, a deliverance from God. Every worshiper in the Bible receive a breakthrough, a deliverance. The big jack of wall never went down to prayer, Raja. You know where the wall went down to? Worship. Worship 7 days with Jericho wall, praising God and worshiping the Lord. This morning when I started to worship, as I said to myself, God, even if you didn't want to stop the message this morning, but Brother Limson, there was an awesomeness in us worshiping this morning. I don't know if you sense it. You know, and maybe, oh Lord God Almighty, maybe the Lord was saying this morning, all he wants was just to worship. Maybe, brother. I want to make a program stop it. Holy Ghost! Brother Sam, you're a veteran in the church of God. You remember them days when worship and worship and program is shut down? Choir can't sing, preacher can't preach, but God wants to worship. I will stop him to a program. Just maybe. Our worship this morning could have been some things in the atmosphere. Just hear me. God, Jesus,
Forgive us, God. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us, Lord. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us. Forgive us. The Holy Ghost will rob him from his worship. The Holy Ghost will rob Jesus from his worship. Oh! Oh! Why? 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 Jesus! I can't say everything when it goes. I can't say everything. We rob him. I can't say we rob him. We rob him! Get him back in the place of worship. Put him back in the place of worship. He needs to worship. Something will be shut down the program. Shut down the program. When the Holy Ghost wants worship, shut down the program. Shut it down. And make him worship and give praise and glory. He alone deserves it. Hey. Hey. Jesus. Somebody worship him. Somebody worship him. Somebody praise him. Somebody glorify him. Hey, 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 hey. The truth shall what? Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus is truth. So once you relate to Jesus, Brother Mario, you have all the truth of God inside of you. I know what I love about the truth of Jesus. You can't worship with hypocrisy. Because the Holy Ghost can show you. You know why we're not seeing a move of God among us as how God wants to move? We're not living a truth. Sometimes me like put the mirror for myself first. Sometimes when me come, there's issue me have to deal with. I'm gonna deal with it, so there's a level of truth that I'm not related to. But when I confess, Brother Mario, and I said, Jesus, I talk too hard to Sister Blair, and I come to church to worship you. I shouldn't talk to her like that.
She's your servant and my wife. So it affects me worship. Until I go back home, I call her up on the phone and say, honey, me sorry. Some of us want to talk to each other in any way and expect God must accept worship. You can't work. A lot of hypocrisy. Me not against her, but me not talk to her. What kind of me know? If God not talk to you for one, how you feel? I'm choosing not to talk to you. But he said, no, I'm not against you. You can say, God, what kind of relationship this? Whatever it is, confess it. Move away from it and live in truth. So Jesus is seeking those. There's two things in the Bible I ever see God talk about. Seeking. Him come to seek and to save that which was lost. And he seeks worshippers. You understand? That's two times I hear God talk about seeking people well faster. Those who are lost and those who need to worship him. So this morning, please, I implore you, stay committed to worship. Stay committed to truth. Stay committed to the Holy Ghost work. I can't finish and I will not finish this day. The next thing you must do, stay committed. Not only to consecration, but stay committed to the cause. What cause are you saved for? When you get saved, you're saved for a cause, you know? Our purpose. Am I right? And because some of us don't know the cause or the purpose why we are saved, we live any and anywhere and do any and anything. But when you know where you're called for, Brother Mario, let me put it in perspective. The ambassador was here. You realize him called to serve. You realize the protocol team and everything around him. Because when you call and know your cause and your purpose, God give you all the support you need. Why some of us are not privileged and better off? Because we're not living the purpose of our cause. We just live arbitrary, any and anywhere. Still, find out what you're called for. One of the things that Jesus Christ said, you shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses unto me. Situation back you up, you know, and it's when you're back down, you know. You know where's my back down? My back down is, Brother Michael, the secret place of the Most High. Anytime you start fighting, my Brother Mario, I mean, I fight you back, you know. I mean, go down. I mean, say, Lord, I come to thee. No other help I know but thee. And if thou withdraw thyself from me, then whither shall I flee? Brother, sometimes best friend draw themself from you. Sometimes good friend God left you. But the song one say, if him draw himself from me, then whither shall I flee? So I make sure that him don't draw away from me. I stay committed to the cause. Hey. Purpose. stay committed. Paul the Apostle in the Bible, when Jesus licked him off of the horse at Damascus, you remember that? Acts chapter 9. The Bible said Jesus blinded him. He was blind for 3 days. Sister, I can't say this to every anybody, but Jesus should allow some condition to happen to you when you see, when it's easy, you know. Because, brother, some people believe that Jesus can allow some things to happen. Me afraid of him. Because sometimes when he do something, sister, me tell the truth, it's painful. Ask David about it. Ask Herod about it. When Herod stand up and talk like him a king, and him do everything, the Bible said, same time the angel of the Lord smote him, and worm heat him up, because he was failed to give glory to God. So what I'm saying to you, Jesus allowed Paul to be blind for 3 days. And then him tell him, same place, him said, Paul, you shall bear my name before the Gentiles, and you shall suffer many things for me. How much of us can get a call and know what we're going to do before we get the call? Some of us run God like Jonah. Jesus tell him we're going to suffer and run God like Jonah. And get in the whale belly. Yeah. And run God and get all people in trouble. Jump out. You know much? Let me tell you something. The Holy Ghost said this. Some of you, the problem you have is because you have connected with people that is living an unfulfilled purpose. You know that, brother? When you're around people that their destiny is not defined, it's be a problem and confusion. You ever see some people, brother Roger, every day them they are school. Then get degree, then they want a master, then they go to PhD, and then they go to something else. They say, you're not going to work. You're not going to find a job. You keep on going to school, a school, a school. What you want? You jump from technician to this, to that, to that. I know you can't define where your purpose is. Those are the miserable, like we around them, brother. They're miserable. Because they don't have a fulfilled call. Stay to completion. Paul knew what he was going to do. And when the time of his completion was coming, 2 Timothy chapter 4, read it. He said, I have fought, for I am now ready to be offered. Jesus have mercy. When the time comes, brother Sam, he said, I am now ready to be offered. You know what they were going to do with Paul then, brother? They were going to put him on a thing named the gallows. You know what a gallows is? They make you lie down. And your neck going out like a thing like this.
A vice.
And there's a sharp, fishing thing come down and just chop off your head. And he said, I'm now ready to be offered. And the time of my departure is at hand. Hey, God Almighty. When your time comes for depart, don't try to fight for steel.
Hey.
When your time of departure come, your time up. Me tell my wife, you know, when me come to leave this world, don't put me pan on. What you call the machine? When my brain dead, let me go. Put me pan on a life-saving machine. Me can't relate to her. Me can't do nothing. When my time come, let me go on. And if me have certain sickness, and them say, I'm going to do surgery. Take the money and buy one pretty car. I enjoy life. And if she married again, whatever. But not spend it all for me. When my time come, let me go on. Leave me, let me go on. No, let me live in an pain and up. I'm cause a problem. I change pampers every day. Leave, let me go on. Leave, let me go on. That's what Paul said. My time of departure is at hand. Go ahead now to the other verse, sister. I have fought a good fight. Lord Jesus Christ. Are you fighting a good fight? Are you fighting a good fight? Are you just fighting to survive? Huh? Some of us just fighting to survive. I have finished my course. That which I get to do, I accomplish it. So the man identified that him finish it, Brother Mario. Sister Patsy, you have to know when you finish something. Me used to play football, I love it. Me have 51 in another 2 weeks or 3 weeks time. Me just play a little of it. But me can't be a professional. Me done. Me done with it. Me might can't play that, me know. Or something else. But no time I go play in a competition in a football. If you then broke up my foot, and me have a little bad knee already, if it get worse, me finish my course in playing football. So me have to give it up. And sometimes, we in the church, we have ministry. Sometimes you outgrow the ministry, give it up. Sunday school teacher, sometimes you have to move on and give it up. Go study and do something else, give it up. Your time come. So Paul said, I have finished my course. And I have kept the faith. Lord Jesus, he has kept the faith. The faith. The definite article, the faith. Nothing else but the faith. And he said, no. Henceforth is laid up for me a crown of righteousness. A crown of righteousness, which the righteous judge shall give me at that day. Oh, there's a day coming, sister, when the righteous judge. Sometimes some people see you wrong, but God see you right. Sometimes people see you wrong, you know. Young convert, sometimes people say you wrong to make a move to start to serve God. But are the right move you make? Because the Bible says, come and taste, Reverend Brown, and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the man that put what? His trust in him. So the Bible said, the righteous judge shall give me on that day. But not unto me only, but unto all them also that love his appearance. Stay to completion. Stay to completion. Let me tell you what Jesus said. Revelation chapter 1, verse 8. I am he that liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive forevermore. Amen. And I have the keys of hell and death. Jesus Christ, stay to completion, Brother Raja. When he went to the cross and he said, it is finished. That was one part of salvation. The cross was finished. But if we never live again, Brother Dan McDaniel, if we never rose from the dead, then our hope will be none and void. That's why he said here in Revelation, I am he that was liveth and was dead. And behold, I am alive. Well, you had to capture that forevermore. While he was living, he was liveth. You understand what I'm talking about? And then he died. And now he lives forevermore. You see, when you stay to completion, there's some benefit when you complete what your assignment is. There's a joy, brother. When you graduate from high school and all of them things, you never get certain privilege. But one thing I do know, when I went to Bible school, and I finished after 3 years and 6 months studying, my wife and I, we got an award. You know where that was? It was an honor. The most persevering student. Brother, we got through hard time going through Bible school. Let me give you a testimony. At one time, I went to the teacher, the principal, and I was going to tell him that we're going to quit because we don't have the money to pay and to finish Bible school. And sister, while I walk to the man door and knock on the man door, and he said, brother and sister Blair, come inside. And he said, what is it? I said, we come to tell you that we're going to finish Bible school. And he said, oh, brother and sister Blair, the Lord spoke to somebody and pay off your school fee. Me want to stop where God start, and God will tell me, saying, can't finish where he start. So stay to completion. Yes, he will see you through. Yes. The Bible says, he that begin a good work will complete it unto the day. Stay committed to completion. Fight a fight. Finish your course. Stay committed. Jesus Christ is coming back soon. Soon and very soon, the song man say, we shall see the King. Soon and very soon. Let me tell you something. I now make nothing hinder me from finishing my course. Sister Patsy, nothing at all. I love my wife dearly. Love her, you know? Trust me. 29 years, going 30 years. Me love her. But if my wife decides to figure backslide, she alone go on. Me not go with her. Me not going with her. Me grow two nice children. And me teach them the way of the Lord. And if them want to depart from it, them go on. As for me, me I stay with me Lord. Me I finish my course. Me I wait till my change come. Me I hold on upon Jesus. Because you know what, brother? My best days are ahead of me. I have passed through the worst if there's a worst time. And my best days are ahead of me. So I can't give up now. I come too far. Sing that song for me, brother, as we pray. You know that song? I can't give up now. I come too far from where I started. Even though the road may get rough sometimes. Brother Raja, a lot of obstacles.
I just can't give up now.
Hey!
I've come too far from where I started from. Nobody told me the road would be easy, and I don't believe he brought me this far to leave me.
Father, I thank you for your word today. Your word bring life, and your word bring light. Father, these are young converts who has committed themselves to the call and to the cause. They have committed themselves to be consecrated and to completion. I pray today, God, that you reveal yourself to them continually, that you strengthen them and teach them your way, so that they incline their heart to you and they will walk before you and walk with you. I come against every plan and every working of Satan. I bind his powers. I drive him out of their life. I shut down his activity. Hey, Satan, I send notice to you in the name of Jesus. Drop your weapon and flee from the life of these young converts. I pray, God, that they will experience your presence, your blessing, and your assurance over their lives. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Praise God. You may be seated. You want us to pray for you too? Come to the altar here. Point your hand towards them. Satan, devil, right now, upon the authority of the word of Almighty God, the word of God, so whatsoever we bind on earth is bound. We see where you're coming from, devil. We see your assignment.
Hallelujah.
We see what you want to do. We send you back. We send you back. And we bind you and confine you. You shall not have a loophole in their lives. Whatever assignment your name come by, today we shut you down and we shut you up. In the name of Jesus. Put a stop order. A stop order. As of today. Today. You can't touch them. You can't touch.
Is there a praise? Come on, I feel that we could just lift our hands and worship the Lord. Aye! Somebody praise him. Ah! Mm-hmm. Somebody praise him. Laba. Come on. Lift your hands. Keep them there. Is there something else you want to say to him in thanksgiving and worship? He's awesome, Church of God in the house. Ah, he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. And we honor the name of Jesus. We praise the name of the Lord, our God. Thank you. We give him thanks. We give him praise. We just want to thank God for the word to our hearts today, that we must continue this journey and we must keep connected to the source, who is Jesus Christ. And we continue to pray for one another, and we continue to give place to the Spirit of Almighty God so that he can operate in his church. Amen. We continue to allow the Holy Spirit to speak. Oh God. We continue. This is the Church of God. And so when he says something to us, we give place to him. Go and ask you to. Quickly, remember at 10 we join the national gathering.
People, if my people will stay consecrated, if my people stay committed, then you will see my glory. I restore the thing that you're looking for. I restore the thing that you're longing for. Stay consecrated, stay committed. I have visited you this day, and I'm changing the order of things. I have visited you this day, and I'm changing the order of things, said the Holy Ghost. Hey!
Come on, lift your hands and thank him. Thank him, thank him. Jesus. Yes, Lord, we receive that word. We receive your word. We will stay consecrated and connected. Lord, we submit to your word. Aye. We submit to your move, God. In Jesus' name. Thanks be to God. What a beautiful name it is, the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. It is. Jesus. Yes, at 10, we are prepared to join the national gathering coming to us from the Portmore New Testament Church of God, where our Bishop Blair would be sharing the message in that service. On Sunday, August 2, we will be having dedication of babies. In addition to dedication of babies, it's going to be our rally in gathering. All members are asked to make a special contribution towards this venture. Envelopes are available from our ushers. So if you have not yet been given an envelope for this cause, please make sure you get one before you go from the ushers. Also, so we have big things going on that day. Also at 6 p.m. that same evening, there will be reception of new members. Those of you who have been given, you have brought in your letter of transfer or recommendation, and you have been interviewed, others who have been interviewed, you are invited to come at 6 p.m. on the 2nd of August. And I must invite all our brothers and sisters here to come and share with us as we welcome our members to the family of God here at Eastwood Parkwood. Daily Vacation Bible School will be held via Zoom. It's going to be the week of August 10 to 14 between the hours of 8:30 to 12:30. And workers are needed for this Vacation Bible School. You may submit your name to Sister Dorothy Lawrence, or you may give your name at the church's office. Although it's virtually, there's still going to be need for workers. So please give your names or speak to Dorothy. Couples Ministry invites us to another exciting meeting with Dr. Carla Dunbar on Tuesday, August 11 at 7 p.m. Focus will be strength-based marriage. It will be done virtually via Zoom and on YouTube. So you can tune in using whatever platform you prefer. So in the light of this pandemic, we continue to have our two services, 7 a.m. and 10:30 a.m., with the exception of today when we begin at 10, joining the live broadcast at Portmore. So Sunday school is at 9:10, and we go to our second service at 10:30. And we are reminded to adhere and follow the protocol of the government. If you have a cough, you stay home. If you're having a fever, stay home. If once it is that you're coming out in public spaces, you're asked to wear your mask. Join us on Tuesdays for fasting service at between the hours of 10 a.m. to 2 p.m., wonderful things are happening in fasting, and you are asked to come and join with us. Yes, you may drop off your tithes and offering as well. during the hours of 9 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday to Friday at our office, or you may use the information for our banking account that is being live streamed there. You can use that medium to put your offering and your tithe. Please remember those who are not well and are at home. Sister Isilda Welch, Isin Hamilton, Pauline Isaacs, Marjorie Linton, Mavis Baxter, Yvonne Hamilton, Olga Myrie, Beverly Boyne, Leonie Cook. Today we would have been saying Sister Joyce Sambers, but she's here, thank God. Veronica, go ahead and clap. Thank you. Veronica Hardware, Brown, Brother Hesley, Henry, Wilfred Ponell, and Sister Vinola Rodney. Sister Nemel sends greetings. She is doing better, but she asks us to continue to pray for her. Sister Thelma Cliff lost her husband, as was announced last week. The funeral service will be at the Romans Catholic Church on Reddins Road at 10 a.m. on August 15. And as many persons are asked to go and give support to a faithful servant who has lost a loved one. Let me ask my... Yes, can you give me that clipping for Stephanie? Let me just ask you to listen to this clipping for a minute or two or so. Turn your...
My EPR family, greetings. This is Stephanie. As most of you know, my son and I left Jamaica for Canada in 2018. Since that time, I undertook and have successfully completed studies in global business management, where, by the grace of God, I graduated with honors in the top percentile of my batch. I also graduated with a distinction in leadership and have also gained certification with the Canadian International Freight Forwarders Association. Upon graduation, I was offered a job, and the Lord is taking me on this new journey. I would just like to take these few moments to big up God for seeing me through these years and being able to achieve these milestones. Special thanks to the following members who either called, prayed, or just sent me motivational thoughts throughout my journey. Sisters Isola Malcolm, Melrose Simpson, Shireen Jones, Carol Hines, Rosalind Francis, Sister Anglin, Reverend Jennifer Brown, Minister Blair, Brothers Junior Brown, Errol Jones, and Desmond Campbell. Last, but surely not least, my head twin sister, Lisa Miller. Thanks for being my riding partner through it all. My dad and mom, Reverend and Sister Sims, you have been a tower of strength to me and Daniel throughout all my journey. I could go on about how you were there for me, but time limits. Just know that I am ever so grateful to you all. If I have erroneously omitted anyone, please, I do appreciate all that you have done for me as well. Daniel and I are doing well, and we crave your continued prayer on this journey. Thank you for all that you have done, and God bless and keep you. Thank you.
Thank you. You may go ahead and cheer if you want to now. Thank you. That was Stephanie telling us about the journey and giving thanks to the Lord. Let me finally, I want to say, remind us or to inform us that our pastor, Reverend Sims, of course, is taking up a new position at the island office, and he will be responsible for ministerial care and training. And so he takes up that job on September 1, 2020. Therefore, on August 30th, the Eastwood Park Road District of Churches will be having an appreciation send-off service for him and Sister Sims. So I'm going to ask us to save that day, to make a note of it, and we want to send off our pastor in style, just to say that our pastor has served us for 15 years and over. And you can clap, man. Come on, man. 15 years and counting. And he is going to be leaving us to another part of the vineyard. And here we want to say thanks to him for the kind of service that he has given to Eastwood Park Road and, of course, to the district of churches. Amen. And we want to say goodbye. He's not gone. He's not dead. He's not retiring. We just want to say you have done well with us at Eastwood Park Road. You have done well with us on the district. And we want to say thank you a lot. And on August 30, we come here. It's going to be one service, and we're going to join in the celebration and say to Reverend Sims, we love you, we appreciate you, God bless you. Now we ask you to put your hands together as we cheer him on and prepare for that great day. If you have celebrated your birthday during the course of this week, Sunday since Sunday to now, we invite you to stand. We want to celebrate with you. Let's go. Praise thee.
Happy birthday, happy birthday to you, dear members. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you, dear members. Happy birthday.
Wonderful. And if you have celebrated your anniversary during that same period, we want to celebrate with you. If you are here, you can stand. And we know that there are persons who are watching us, maybe celebrating. We are not seeing you, but we are joining in the celebration.
Happy anniversary to you. Happy anniversary. Ooh. Happy anniversary.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Just one more thing I think I have left out is on second Sunday of August, there's going to be a baptismal service at the Caymanas River again. There are persons who are asking about baptism, and there's going to be one, and it starts at 7 a.m. So if you are ready and prepared, there's going to be one on second Sunday of August. Thank you. Which is the 9th? The 9th? Okay, second Sunday is the 9th. So yes, it's going to be on the 9th of August, which is second Sunday. And it will take place at the Caymanas River, the one that they, same place where they added last week. So if you're desirous of being baptized, you can speak to the Evangelism Director, Sister Patsy Banks, or you can speak to the Director of Young Converts Ministry, Sister Melrose Simpson, and I'm sure I saw her somewhere. So, or if you can't get through to any of those, you can speak to us at the office, and we will give the information to them. God richly bless you. Have yourself a great day. I invite the moderator to come, and he's going to be doing the benediction.
Praise the Lord. Wasn't it wonderful? Have you been blessed? No, I'm gonna like that yesterday. Have you been blessed? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Stand for benediction. We're going home. And as Rev say, the live stream from the Portmore New Testament starts at 10, so if you're interested, you can remain and be a part of it, okay? And now may the saving grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the full fellowship of God the Holy Father, rest, remain, and abide with us all, now and forevermore. And everyone say, amen. Go home in peace. Thank you.
All right, remember we have to clear the environment for the sanitizing, so do that quickly, please.